Tuskegee University is very pleased to be celebrating its 130th anniversary as an 1890s university. Under the Morrell Act of 1890, Tuskegee University was one of several land-grant institutions that were identified as schools that did not discriminate on the basis of race. So Tuskegee, along with other HBCUs, was able to offer admission to people of color, to Negroes, to freed slaves. We offered access and the ability to have higher education at a time when no one else in the country would afford us an admission. The resources that we enjoyed really helped to build our capacity in the area of agriculture and mechanical sciences. For Tuskegee, this has been especially important as the work of George Washington Carver, for example, in the area of agricultural science and research has been a stalwart and has helped us to become recognized as an institution that has helped the work of Black Belt farmers throughout the South. In the present, we are very pleased to have been recognized as a center of excellence among 1890s universities and to have the 1890 scholars that support our students in their endeavors here. Those are some of the most important attributes, some of the most important accomplishments of our solidification of our work as 1890 universities. Some of the more recent successes of our being an 1890s university is our being named a center of excellence and our ability to have 1890 scholars, scholarships that support our students who are doing research in agricultural and extension sciences, thereby continuing the important legacy of agricultural research that was started so long ago when George Washington Carver came to Tuskegee University. We know that there are many challenges ahead of us. We know that it's important for donors and legislators to understand why it's so important for us to have the kind of funding, the kind of state funding that matches the federal funding that is stipulated in the Morrell Act of 1890. We continue to work to advance this because we know that we need the resources in order to continue the great legacy of work. We look forward to celebrating the 130th anniversary, but also to working hard so that we can diligently say at our next major anniversary, we are getting all of the resources that are afforded to us through the Morrell Act of 1890.